Good morning, everyone. Happy Sunday. Well, if you guys are following us on the channel on the community tab, you saw yesterday when I posted the picture of me and William at Lansdowne Moody that I purchased the Tiger Cat too. A lot of you guys thought I was going to get the Patriot, which I wanted the Patriot, but there really wasn't a full-blown commercial model of the Patriot. So we decided to go with this guy, 52-inch. So we're going to get a couple of passes this morning on it, on our commercial property. And the sun's out, so it may not be that great. last little bit and we'll be done for the day. I'm gonna come back in the morning, finish up the trimming. I just want to come out and mow a little bit.
All right, I was doing everything at 4.5, but I decided to drop it down to 4 inches, a little bit cleaner cut. Let's go back over here real quick.
Okay, folks, well, I know it's real shaded, but man, let's go take a look at the grass. Hold on, let me fix my glasses here. Cause you know, I like to talk eyeballs to eyeballs. I don't like talking with glasses on to you guys. Mo better. Get it? Mo better. Okay, so this machine cuts really good. You know, I was checking out underneath the deck last night when I was cleaning out the garage. And those blades are razor sharp, man. I've never had blades that, you know, when I bought a mower brand new, they were just razor sharp. I was just like, wow, this is incredible. Anyway, so this is, you know, our commercial property. And, you know, it's not our largest property. Our residential properties are larger ones. But, dude, this thing cuts good. Nice and clean. It doesn't really stripe. Doesn't really stripe. Now, maybe, now I know the sun now. In this, let me take that back, because the sun isn't hitting the grass yet. We're still in the shade, so let's wait till the sun hits it to see what happens. But the Ferris, the Walker, Kubota stripe exceptionally well, and the Skag shouldn't be any different, you know. But gives a clean cut. Real happy about it. Let's take a look at, you know, the grass here. I see that. That's relatively clean cut. You know, it's not bad. Here's another one. Oh, like a Ginsu knife. Ching. So the cut quality is pretty good. This terrain is pretty bumpy. It's not the bumpiest terrain that I have, but pretty bumpy. I'll tell you right now though, even with the super duper seat on that that Skag, it's still bumpy. I mean, it's nice and cushiony. I like that. But when you're on the Ferris to stand on, you don't feel half these bumps. And I couldn't keep that mower straight. You know, I'm still trying to get used to the controls, you know. They are touchy-feely, you know. So I need to play with it a little bit more, get used to it. But on the stand-on mowers, I don't know why. Stand-on mowers, it's easier for me to get them to stay going straight. This one I have a little bit of a hard time. But I think it's because I'm just not used to the hydros yet. You know, the handles and things like that. But it cut good, man. You know, I have no complaint. I can see now the sun's starting to come up. I can see the stripe a little bit. So I think it'll do good. I wanted to do it at 4.5, but it just didn't look like I just cut it. So I dropped it down to 4. Plus, I just love mowing. So I was like, hey, what the hell? All right, let's go on this side. And then we're going to go grab some breakfast and just chill out the rest of the day. I'm not gonna do the trimming today. I'm gonna come tomorrow and do the trimming with Caden. Yeah, I can see a little bit. I need to go over it some more, but you know, it isn't bad. You know, but anyways, this mower's great so far. I'm digging it. It's got the Tiger Eye monitoring system, which is totally cool, man. Let's check that out. All right. Let's see here. So you're sitting in your seat, right? And you go to turn the key. All these things light up. That means they are in the position they need to be in order to start. Now watch this seat position here. I'm going to get up and it's going to go out. See that? It won't start without your keister sitting in the seat. So that's cool. It's got two tanks, you know. Okay, it's got two tanks. So total, I think, is like 9.5 gallons. That a ton or what, man? So we lowered the ROPs because they wouldn't slide in the garage on the trailer. All right. I'm going to do a review of this later. But I'm digging it so far. You know, it has a great cut. Now, we're not cutting anything, you know, crazy over here. This is weekly cut stuff. But it's thick San Augustine, you know, but you could feel when something, you know, is under load, or you could feel when there's a little bit of stress. But with this bigger engine, boy, it just plows through that grass. It's got the high velocity plus deck, 52 incher, triple blades. And I'm gonna see if I can get some laser edge blades for this guy. I love this contour shape. I mean, look at that, man, on this fender. Look at that. See, it comes down, goes in, and flares right back out. That's cool, man. Electronic fuel injection. Like I said, we'll do a better review later. This right here comes up. You know, that helps keep some of the stuff from going down in there. It's got your oil drain thing guy there. Totally excited, man. Totally excited. But anyways, guys, that's about it for now. It's a 30-minute video. So we'll get you guys some good footage. But I hope you guys are having a good weekend, relaxing anyways. It's pretty hot. It was 108 yesterday. And it'll get up to 112, 115. Of course, this is all with heat index, but still, it's hot. So, I'm already sweating. Anyways, guys, have a good Sunday. Get all your equipment ready for the week, you know, today or tonight or something, at least some of it, and then that way you're ready to roll tomorrow morning. Other than that, you guys take care, and remember, #StaySweaty.